a representative from our Sunday school class. Not only is he busy in church and he loves the Lord, he's also doing well in school and in sports. They had a game yesterday. It was a very close game. They just didn't win. But I kept a winning spirit.
There you go.
I present to you now, Ivan Vaughn.
Rosa Parks. One day Rosa Parks was leaving work. She was very tired and took the bus home. A white man wanted her seat. Rosa said nicely that she didn't want to get up. She was arrested for refusing to give her seat to a white passenger. Now I got a test. Why didn't she give up her seat?
She wasn't physically tired. She was tired of her experience as a black woman.
Why was she arrested?
Okay, I'm gonna do Catherine Dunham. Catherine Dunham, her phrase was, go within every day and find the inner strength so that the world will not blow your candle out. Mm-hmm. Come on, baby, light my fire. That was my part I had. I'm making history right there. As we know, history, everybody's history is important. And just so happened, African Americans' history, most of it, has been wiped out. So that's why we have a month to celebrate, to help everybody to know that everybody played a part in building America. Catherine Dunham. Catherine Dunham was a prodigy dancer and a choreographer. She did African dance. She did African dance, and she was a genius. She was an anthropologist. And in the 20th century, she translated rich history and culture of her African ancestors into stunning artistic choreography that captivated and thrilled her audiences all over the world. Hear the music. Feel it is what she taught people. Multidimensional throughout her prolific dance career. Also, respect to contributors as an author, producer, social activist, educator, and a silver screen actress. And then they would echo back for the African American messages that they gave to one another. So when I go, oh, oh, then I want you to do the same thing. Ready? Go. Oh, oh, she did that all over the world. And she was known for how she gave the Americans dance techniques, Meanwhile, she was an excellent student. She was one of the first African-American women to attend the University of Chicago, where she not only earned a bachelor's, a master's, and a doctoral degree in anthropology, but was also taught and mentored by the top professors in her field, leading innovators. Her passion for dance naturally inspired her academic curiosity and focused her research on dances of Africa. Displaced the West Indies during the transatlantic slave trade of the 1500s and the 1800s. Just to name a few things, she spent 10 months traveling abroad, Jamaica, Trinidad, Tobago, Haiti, and she taught them how to dance and how to have religion and how to love God. When Dunham returned to Chicago, she was recognized for her dancing, was pulling her two different directions, performance versus her research. So that goes to show, tell you that not only can you have one career, you can have two careers, you can have whatever God has put in you.
Yeah.
Do it all together and ask God to give you the order.
Yeah.
And this is the life of Catherine Dunham.
Not on my watch,
you're not
gonna
come
at this.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
But, look at what
was burned so bad.
Jesus!
And they were gonna send her to the hospital, the children's hospital, because, you know, her eyes were swollen shut. They would have to give her those baths every day, you know, she'd cry, 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 but God delivered her.
Oh! and comes to us from text taken from 1 Corinthians 13, 1 verse 11, and then Ephesians 14, Ephesians, the book of Ephesians, 4, 14. All right? You don't have to stand up for this one. First Corinthians 13:11. It reminds us when I was a child, I spoke as a child.
Yes.
I understood as a child. I thought as a child.
Yes.
But when I became man, I put away childish things.
Yes.
And then, Shante, Ephesians 4 and 14 says that we henceforth be no more children. Toss to and fro and carry about with every wind of doctrine by the slave of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. From the subject, stop playing church and grow up.
Stop playing church.
Playing church and grow up. Apostle Paul wrote this epistle.
All right, all right.
To the church at Ephesus.
Yeah.
Because when he looked around and observed the congregation was full of folks who didn't know how to conduct themselves as mature Christians. I stopped by this morning to let you know immaturity behavior may be acceptable in the world. But it's not acceptable in the house of God. The Bible says, Brandon, that we are a peculiar people. We are special people. And a royal priesthood. That means we are somebody.
Right.
And we need to act like
we
are somebody. If we want to be used by God.
All right.
We need to grow up and get rid of our outdated toys, baby bottles, and diapers. Even though some of us have some age on us, we still have some immature habits. Some of us are caught up in what I like to characterized as arrested development, which has contaminated the church. Instead of having mature, grown-up folks sitting in the pews with gray hair, we have silly women and sorry men raising sassy children.
Growing up.
Yeah. are nothing but educated idiots. Suffering from arrested development. It is time to grow up. I stopped by this morning to let somebody know that God has designed a growth plan for all of us, physically as well as spiritually. Let me see if I can make it plain. All of us who come to church at one time or another will fall in one of these categories. Take for instance an infant. When you are an infant, the whole world is centered around you. And you know, Jack, what button to push when you want some attention. Some of us would cry our eyes out so we can get some attention. I said some of us would cry our eyes out so we can get some attention. Oh, you know you done it. All of us have done it. We have cried just to get some attention. And we didn't care who we got it from. Oh, help me somebody. Y'all don't want to pray with me, but I want to preach this thing. Acting like an infant. Every time you see them, they are crying about something. If it ain't one thing, it's another. Just want some attention. Then you have what I like to refer as childhood development stage. That's the stage that a child needs to be shown and taught everything to do and how to do it. How to pop it. How to walk. How to talk. How to eat. Table food. You know about table food, don't you? You know about table food. Your mama will get the food. Put it in her mouth, chew it up.
In your mouth.
And on it. Say what? Now, we wouldn't let daddy do it. It had to be mama.
Preacher!
That was after weaning you off the bottle.
All right.
You need to be taught everything. Some of you see where I'm going with this. Whether you believe it or not, I know some adults just like that.
Help us, Pastor.
They want everybody to tell them about everything, especially when it comes to the Word of God. They don't want to study the Word for themselves. However, surely I read the other day, you ought to study. See, even though a preacher preach the word, you ought to be able to follow it in your Bible. Just don't take his word. Find out by yourself.
Amen.
Then we have what is called the adolescent stage. Which is known as I know what I'm doing, and you can't tell me nothing. At adolescent stage, they will challenge everything you say and are known for talking back, eyes rolling, helping somebody, and working that neck.
right.
You will become like the Dead Sea.
All right. All right.
Huh? You know what the Dead Sea is?
Yeah.
That body of water that takes in.
Yeah.
But nothing ever goes out.
All right. All right.
And if you aren't careful, you'll start stinking.
Right.
Can bring you to the point of becoming spiritually mature.
That's right.
And stop you from acting so childish.
I know it.
Church, when you let Jesus come in and you get to know him for yourself, he will deal with your problem of being childish.
Yes, he will. That's true.
You have too many folks in church today acting like child. But he can only stop you from acting like a child if you get to know him for yourself. What are you saying, Brother Preacher? Can't nobody.
Nobody.
I said nobody.
Nobody.
Do me
like Jesus.
Like Jesus. Can't nobody. Do me like the Lord. Are you gonna pray with me?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
Yes.
I don't know about you.
Yes.
But Jesus is the world to me.
Yes.
And I will not let trouble.
All right.
Hardship.
Mm-hmm.
Persecution.
All right.
Famine.
Mm-hmm.
Nakedness.
Amen.
Or danger.
Mm-hmm.
Or sword.
Right.
Neither death.
Nor
life.
All right.
Will separate me.
Right.
From the love of God.
Yeah.
I said, no.